Welcome back. Now you've created your basic pages. You've also connected your data source to Softr. You've visualized your data as a list and list details block. And in addition, you've also uploaded your users to your app. So in this video, we're going to go over all the different sign in and sign up options that Softr has available to you. In addition, we'll quickly show you how to create your password reset page, as well as go over the profile page, which allows your users to edit and update information on their profile. Softr provides you with a lot of options for granting users access to your app. We talked a bit about this in the last video, but we're going to dive a bit more into it in this one. For example, a public marketplace is probably going to want to have different sign-in options than a private internal tool for a company or business. We'll go over what this looks like in detail in this video. So let's dive in. Now, if I dive back into my Softr app, remember, I'm creating a simple employee portal. I'm going to go ahead and set up my sign up form first, which will allow users to obviously sign themselves up for the app. So remember, Softr created this page for us. So I'm going to go to the pages panel and then sign up. Perfect. So if we click into this form, we will see the block settings appear on the right hand side. So you can do a number of things to style this form. You can upload a different logo for your company. You can also change the text of the title. You can also change the font and all of the styling within here. Additionally, you can create a background image if you want to. Now, here you have the ability to toggle on sign up with Google. Now, we're not going to go into exactly how to do that in this video, but just know that's an option that's available to you with a few more steps. Now, in the case of my employee portal, I don't really want the public to be able to sign up to this app. I only want employees from my company to be able to. So I either have the option to manually upload my users like we did in the previous video, or you could also, as an option, use the domain-based signup feature. This essentially allows you to only allow signups from users that have a domain that's potentially within your business. Let's take a quick look. So if we toggle on domain-based signup, I can add my allowed domain right here by just typing it in. So if we remember my domain from my fictitious employee portal, it's Parks and Rec. So I'm gonna put that in right here, Parks Rec, hit tab. And essentially what that does is it tells Softr, hey, only let people with this domain sign up to our app. Additionally, you can add as many domains as you need. All right, moving right along. So you have your name, email, and password at the minimum is what's required. You can also add additional fields here as long as your data source is properly set up to your app. So let's say like I want to add a dropdown and I want this dropdown to correspond with the department field here. So what I would do is add dropdown and then I would make the placeholder say department, you can see here. And then we map it to the correct field. So I want to map it to, like we just said, department. Now, the last step is anytime you're doing an input type that's a dropdown like this, you need to add the value of the options. And you need to remember that they are case sensitive. So typically, I like to go in, if possible, and just copy and paste them exactly how they are in my database. And then I'm going to toggle it on as required. Okay, great. So now I'm going to quickly just update some of the design styles to represent the app that I'm building. I uploaded a logo, changed the font a bit on the text, and then I added name, email, password, and department. Great. Now, in my case, maybe instead of me manually adding the employee information, I want them to sign up and create their own profile and add all of the information about themselves on their own. For this, we would create a signup form as usual, pulling their name and company and email address. In addition, we would make sure our domain-based signup is on so that only employees with this domain are allowed to sign up. Then we create a specific page called the profile page, which utilizes the profile block where they can edit and update all of their information. Luckily, Softr has created this page for us once again. So navigating to the pages panel and going to user profile, which was created in our onboarding, you'll notice there's going to be a very simple user profile block here. You can also add a user profile block by going to add block, then go to dynamic, and you'll go to user accounts, scroll down to user profile. Perfect. So So I already started filling in some of the user profile details down here, but let me show you guys what this looks like. With the user profile block, the full name and email address are already filled in because, as you remember, Softr already recognizes that this person is logged in. If we want the employee to then update all of their information, we need to create individual form fields that correspond with the form fields in our employee list. You do that by clicking into the profile block, heading over to the form field section, and then you will add all of your remaining fields to correspond with these fields here, just like we've done previously. So I'll do the first one together, and then I'll let you guys finish on your own. So the first one we're gonna do, location. So if I want my employee to fill out the location, we need to choose the dropdown, and then we need to map it to location. And then if you remember, this one has different options, which we need to manually copy and paste into Softr. All right, great. Now I'm gonna type location under the label, turn it on as required, and looks good. Take some time to fill out the rest of your profile block with all of the corresponding fields in your users tab. Once you're done, hit publish, and you can preview your work here. Now let's run through the sign up flow so you can see your work in action. So remember, you can always go to preview and add test users. So let's go to sign up. And again, remember, pretend like I'm an employee and my manager has just sent me this employee portal and asked me to register and sign up as well as update my profile information. So let me add my email address, and remember the domain needs to be parksandrec.com or else I won't be able to sign up. My department, I agree, sign up. Cool. So just pretend like this is designed for the corresponding business. Obviously, this is all dummy text and dummy images. But as you can see, if I go up here and click on my profile, you'll see here, now I'm able to add all of my additional information and even upload an avatar image. So let me do that really quickly here. All right, so I filled everything out. I'm gonna simply click update profile here. And then as you should be able to see, all that information on the users table will now be updated. One last thing to check out is if you go directly to employee list, which we set up in an earlier video in this series, you'll see there's my profile. It's already been added to the directory, as well as my additional corresponding information. Don't worry, we're gonna style all of this later and make it look good. Pretty cool, right? Okay, let's quickly go back over some of the additional sign-up options that Softr offers. So if we go back to sign up, let's just go to add blocks, and I'll walk you through a few of these options. So we obviously already used the sign up form. You also have a sign up with a side image, which can look really nice. You can also sign in with single sign on, and you can do open ID single sign on. So lots of different options. We'll go over how to set up SSO in a future video. Okay, what about signing back in? So obviously signing up is important, but then you're gonna want your employees to be able to sign back in. And as you can see on a lot of the sign up forms, you have the option to add the sign in button. And then for a lot of apps, it's common to have a sign in and sign up button in the header. So again, Softr created this page for you. So go to pages and sign in. So as you can see, I've already updated the logo to reflect my fictitious brand. Let's take a look at some of the options for signing in. So if you go to add block, you can do sign in with form. This is great if you just need a simple sign in. Additionally, you can do sign in with side image, similar to the sign up option. You can do Google sign in. You can also sign in with a code where you will enter your email to receive the authorization code, as well as SMS. Lastly, you can sign in with a phone code. Okay, so back to our sign-in form that we've created for this app. If I click into it, we can see the settings over here under features. Similar settings to sign up, we can change the logo, the title, the background image. We can turn on sign-in with Google. Additionally, email and password are already set up for us. And then you can see here, the button sign-in is already set up for us to sign in. You can also toggle on or off forgot password, which we'll get into in just a second. And then as you can see below, show sign up is toggled on, which means we can also offer the user a chance to head to the sign up button if they haven't yet signed up and they've somehow landed themselves on the sign in page. All you have to do here is make the action open page sign up and then head them over to your sign up page that you've created or that Softr's created for you in your onboarding. Lastly, on sign in, you can direct your users to a specific page. So for example, if I want my employees to be directed to the employee directory immediately upon signing in, you can set those parameters here. Great. Now let's quickly show how we're going to implement our forgot password. So if you scroll down to having trouble logging in, you can add the action, open page, and of course, Softr's created this forgot password page for you. So all you simply need to do is connect it here and hit publish. But again, you can view it under pages, forgot password. And Softr pretty much sets it up for you. You can add your logo and title, but as you can see down here, the action button is set as recover password, and Softr will automatically send an email to the user that allows them to recover their password. Now, also you'll notice if we go under pages and we go to user profile, you can also see that users have the ability to change their password within this section as well. This is really handy if a user wants to change their password for whatever reason. You can simply just add it here. And again, Softr just sets that up for you on the back end. Cool. Okay, now you have successfully created your sign in, sign up, and password page. And you've also learned how to use the user block to allow your users to update their profile. In the next video, we're gonna cover some of the more powerful Softr features, specifically around visibility. You will learn how to set specific areas of your app to be visible to some users versus others. In addition, we will learn about giving certain users various permissions depending on certain parameters that you set for them. So let's keep going.